I'm so glad you can join us today. We're making a slimline card today using our brand new stamp set, Beach Babes. We're also using the brand new paper pad, Dots for Summer. We're going to make our own background using the paper pad. Here's some more inspiration from our design team. They had so much fun playing with these cute little elephants illustrated by Tammy Cremins. So I hope you stick around and make this slimline card with me today. I start off by cutting a bunch of strips in the same size. I use washi tape to tape them together. That just makes it easier for when I cut it out. They're all put together. I don't have to piece them back together. So I like doing that. So here is our background all ready to go. I do a sunset background with various inks in my stash. I end up covering up most of my sunset. That was a little disappointing, but that's okay. So I created a hill and I created water. So I have many layers on this card. Now, if you don't have a hill die, you can certainly just use your scissors and cut out a hill. You could also just trace it out with a pencil and then use your scissors to cut it out. Same with the waves. So I used distress inks and other inks from my stash to color up the sand, the waves, and the sky. So I did splash a little bit of water on those waves and pulled it up with a towel. I like that look for water. Same with the sand. And then I have a perfect spot for my sentiment. I think this background turned out fabulous. I just love all the summer rainbow colors. So I'm gonna add this black little frame right there. So it's gonna kinda tie it all together. I'm gonna use some liquid glue for that. Make sure I got that on there straight. Now I can add the sky layer, and it's such a shame I didn't realize that the waves were gonna go up that high, so I kinda am just covering up my whole sunset there. That's okay. So let's go ahead and add that to our sky. Now our third layer goes on. So I'm just gonna put my magnets on here so it dries flat. Now we'll go ahead and put our last layer on. I'm gonna glue this one to here because I'm gonna pop these up together. It'll just make it easier for me. And then his little hat is so cute. Tammy did a really great job illustrating the stamp set. Look how cute. And I love how I pulled in all the colors together so the card looks cohesive. So we're just gonna put some foam dots on the back, and I did accidentally cut his little ear right there. So I'm gonna cover that up with some splashes. Okay, let's add these to our card. We've got foam tape on the back for a nice lift. So we'll add our little beach babe right about there. Okay, we'll add our next grouping right here in the center. What do they say? Elephants never forget. So we have our sentiment, have an unforgettable summer. So it's just perfect for these guys. And I'm gonna put this little splash over here. So he just got out of the water, I think. He was swimming in there with his goggles. So he's got some water splashing off of him. So there's our little scene. Now let me show you a little trick for when you're fussy cutting and you have little spaces on the inside. So what I do is I find a marker that's similar to the color in the background. So this bee G15 looks pretty close, and I'm just going to take that and fill it in. Okay, so it doesn't look so like you forgot something. So here I want to take this grayish brown, so probably my W's, W5. Take that and just fill that in to match the background there. And I could do that here on these little drip marks. So let's fill in this white space. See that? That just looks so much better. And I'm going to do W3 for this one. And that just matches our background perfectly. Hides all that white. See, my coloring wasn't that great right here, so I'm just going to hide that white. And there you have it. Just love how this turned out. It's so cute. Before you go, if you enjoyed the video, leave a big thumbs up and don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Thanks for stopping by, guys, and I'll see you real soon.